Hey, what's going on? I want to show you how I was able to get my computer to play Doom. And I'm not going to spend too much time going through each bit of the code because everything I've done here was essentially taken from a very great YouTuber and machine learning engineer, Nicholas Renotte. If you guys are interested in machine learning, I highly, highly suggest following him. He's going to be able to go more in detail and break down exactly how this code works. I was able to replicate it by following his video, and if you're interested in doing it yourself, you should definitely check out his video. But as far as this video, I just want to show you what's possible with reinforcement learning and go over some cool aspects of the code that I found really interesting, and hopefully you will too. So let's go ahead, jump into my computer, and get started. So the first thing you'll need to do is come to VizDoom. It allows developing AI bots to play Doom. And so this is a very, very handy package for Python, Julia, Java, C++, all that good stuff. It's got tutorials, competitions, and documentation. You'll need to download that, and you can begin playing Doom. Basically, you're training a computer to play Doom. And once you're in your Jupyter notebook, you'll need to install VizDoom, and you'll also want to clone the gentleman who made VizDoom and clone all of his GitHub repositories, and then import them all, import random, time, as well as NumPy, because you'll need those. Initialize game with Doom game that comes from VizDoom. And then load the configuration. So if you go through a bunch of files in the VizDoom and you go to scenarios, you'll find a defend the center configuration file that's going to hold a lot of the actions that are needed for playing our game. So in this instance, we're going to do defend the center, which, if you can think about it, it's our Doom guy in the center of a room and he's surrounded by aliens and demons who come to attack him, and he has to defend his little center. So a pretty straightforward environment that we're going to be building an agent to train in. And then we're going to initialize actions. There's three actions, which is look around and shoot. And we also need to get game state. Get game state is like everything that's needed for initializing a gym, which we'll see later on. I want to show you what this looks like. I'm going to go ahead and run. So I actually need to redo this, it looks like. And here it is. So at the currently there's nothing going on. So let's just keep rolling through that because we actually haven't told it to do anything. But if we ask it to loop through and play a few games, if we come look at it, you can see here. Can I make this bigger? I don't think so, because yeah, can't really make it bigger because the agent only sees this much room in its gym, and as you can see, it's just shooting randomly. It keeps dying. It's not really hitting anyone. So in its current state, it's not doing very well, but at least we know that the environment has loaded and we can shoot the gun. So from here, it should just be all uphill. Or I should say, we should just be getting better from here. There's nowhere worse that we can go. Let's go ahead and close this out. So the way reinforcement learning works is basically you have an agent, and that agent is trained within what's called a gym. So what we're going to be doing is installing OpenAI's gym packages. OpenAI is a pretty big machine learning developer. So we're going to install their gym for training, and then we're going to configure it so that it accepts the environment of the VizDoom game. So these are the imports that we need to bring on. And this is a class, VizDoom, of several different functions here. I'll just go through it really quick. So when we launch VizDoom, we're going to initialize a new environment. We're not going to render the frames for training. And we're going to load in the game. We're going to load in the config. So pretty much everything we've done up here, we're just going to put it inside a class. And we're going to start the game. We're going to create a new action space. And we've defined what that action space is going to look like. And then this here is like getting the actions that our agent can take in the environment. All the information that we need returned for the training, and it's going to initialize all those things into state, reward, done, info. So this is the state of the game, the rewards that the agent is being fed, whether the game's done, and other information that we need to make the training better. We reset a new game when we start up a new game, and then of course we have a close down the game. The grayscale is so that it makes training a bit easier if the agent doesn't have to understand colorization. So we're going to make everything grayscale for the training. Did I already run this? I think I did. No, I didn't. So let's run that. And then here we're just going to set the environment as VizDoom Gym. We're going to render it as true. So it should pull up another window with our Doom guy. Yes, it is. And of course, he's not doing anything. So because we haven't actually started the game, but we can initialize the gym that way. So that's good. We've just reset the environment. And now we're going to view the game state. So baseline 3 is where we're going to check our environment to make sure that it is acceptable for our model. This is pretty important, just to make sure that everything works. And it probably won't work because, in fact, I do have it open. Okay, good. So if I didn't have this window open, it'll come up some sort of weird. I don't know why it's not coming up. Anyway, we have the Doom game open. We just can't see it for some reason. We're just going to make sure that it works, and it does. And we need to close our environment because it's slowing things down. So I'm just going to slow it down. We also need to get a callback because this is a recurrent neural network. So it needs to be able to recur on itself to make changes to itself while it's training. So we're just going to do that by getting torch vision, torch audio, PyTorch, all that good stuff. And then we're also going to be using baseline for it as well. We're going to need to import OS and callbacks. And then this is another class, train and login callback. So again, this is pretty difficult, but what this is doing is setting up a way for the model to save its basically its biases and weights. If you're familiar with machine learning, it saves the pathways from one neural network to the next layer and so on and so forth. So it's going to save its weights throughout it. And in fact, and then basically in the end state, what it will do is save several different iterations of the model as it's being trained through its steps. So as you can see here, I've got like best model 1000, best model 2000, 3000, 6000, 7000, all the way up to 10,000. It's because we're going to chain through it like 10,000 times, and it's going to save as the best model and save it in this directory here. So we're going to put in a checkpoint directory as well as a log directory. Checkpoint directory, just like I said, it saves this good stuff here. Like it saves the model for us so that we can actually test it. And then the log directory is going to be what logs throughout the training so that we can see how our model is being trained. If that makes sense. Probably didn't, but I did my best. And so let's initialize those directories and then, of course, callback. And then we'll use the callback down here when we actually train our model. So we're going to import PPO from baseline 3. We're going to initialize a non-rendered environment. And then we're going to train the model as the PPO. So this is just saying it's using a CPU because my GPU isn't, I don't know, I'm not using my GPU for some reason. And then it's telling me how it's wrapping the environment. So here we go. We're going to call model.learn time steps 10,000 callback equals callback. And the callback, again, like I said, is basically this class here and all the functions within it. So I'm going to actually start training it. Because I think I need to redo a lot of this stuff. So let's go ahead and train it. This might take a good minute or two. When you go to train this here. Okay, so it's going to be in PPO 3. So it's going to come up with some information here in a second. And basically, it's not going to make a whole lot of sense. What you want to do if you're doing this, we can open our command line here. And here in the command line, my mouse is dying or something. Okay. Here in the command line, if you go to the directory where you've saved those logs, so in preparation for this video, I was doing PPO2, and I was training another model in PPO2. If you type in tensorboard dash dash log directory equals period, it'll probably give you this, you know, error warning here and tells you to go to localhost 6006. If you go there, it's going to bring up this tensorboard here, and it's going to give you all of your, basically everything you need to see for you to understand how your model is being trained. I mean, this is looking good. It means that we're surviving longer. This is also looking good. It means we're training in the right direction. What's weird about when I was training this model was that our policy gradient was getting like really bad. Typically, you'd want this to go in the other direction. And our value loss was also going up. I don't exactly think that's what we wanted. So this wasn't training very well when I was first doing it. I'm actually interrupt this because I don't think we're going to be using this model anyway for our test. But at this point, once this is done and it's gone through 10,000 steps, you should have something looking like this in your directory under your train defend. And you're going to play around and see which model is the best. It should be hopefully this 10,000 one. I think when I actually go, yeah, I'm going to use the 10,000 model here. So let me just interrupt this kernel here because I don't need to be training something right now. So let's say we've trained the model. I'm happy with it. We're going to open stable baseline 3 evaluation policy. We're going to load our agent. We're going to load a rendered version of our environment. And then we're going to see how it performs. So let's go ahead, do that, do this. So at the moment, it's not going to do anything. It's just loaded the environment, and we have the model in here as well. Let's go ahead and evaluate it. You can evaluate the mean reward using evaluate policy, the model, the environment, and then passing through the number of evaluation episodes. It's going to go really fast. So let's just check it out real quick. So if you remember before, our model was just randomly shooting and he was quickly dying. In this instance, you can see he's actually killing things, but you might notice every once in a while he'll just stand there and wait to be killed like that. And you wonder, like, why is he just waiting to be killed? It's because he's run out of ammo and he can't defend himself. So this is pretty cool. I mean, it's really hard to see because it's going so fast. So this next kernel down here is, so actually I'm just going to interrupt this. So this next tier is just going to, you know, it's going to go through each episode in 100. And it's just going to slow things down and tell us what our total reward for the episode is. So let's go ahead and run that. And when I pull this back up, you should be able to see. Yeah. So here he's going ahead and he's defending the center. He's finding targets. That was a missed fire. He's looking for targets. Yeah, missed fire, missed fire. Misfire. I don't know why he was doing that. There's one. Shoot that. There you go. So much better than before. Before he was just getting randomly shot. Here he's not really prioritizing who to shoot, and there's still some instances where he'll just shoot randomly into the void there. But yeah, pretty cool. This is what's possible with reinforcement learning, and especially using video games. And if you're sort of new to this space, hopefully this is somewhat inspiring. It was something, one of the first things I did, and it was really inspiring for me. There's a lot of improvement that could be made on this, and there's a lot more environments in the configurations with VizDoom that hopefully I'll be able to explore and maybe make this into a series if you guys enjoy it. Let me know in the comments, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.